don't give me trouble now.
Freshened up and ready to fight.
With a bit of luck, we'll meet a beholder.
I'll take that.
Thank you.
These fungal spores are everywhere.
Is a canyon, and the words echo from every crevasse.
They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. You're coming.
Taking position. That'll fill my pack. That might be worth a look. What's inside?
seems the Githyanki are keen to reclaim the artifact I carry. I can't afford that to happen. In fact, none of us can. That thing is shielding us somehow. I don't want to know what happens if we lose it. Agreed. There's not much we can do but press forward.
Light on my feet.
Airborne spore. Fungal, I suspect. Whatever it was, I stand at the ready. Control your thoughts. It seems I'm not the only one listening.
They're coming. You're coming.
May the gods take you first. Don't waste a step. Think you can take me on? That comes easy these days.
Thank you.
on the move.
At the ready. Anything of use? What's in here? Step carefully. There's a trap. Very well. Give it a shot. Another step forward. More for me. Mm-hmm. there's a trap.
Traps about.
On my way. Open up. Maybe I need more pockets. Thank you.
Masks, known to cause confusion. Best not get too close.
Shouldn't have made me your enemy. Broken bones. Must have fallen. Let's see. Thank you.
slender drow blade impales the stone before you, keeping a silent vigil. This blade was a warrior's sacrifice to Elis Stray. Blood can only be honored with blood. The drow script inscribed on the blade flickers and glows. It rises from the stone, hanging in the air in silent offering.
What's next, I wonder? I'll take this way.
No one stopped me yet. Always room for more.
Oh.
forward.
I can't afford to stay idle. I must keep going.
Still alive, so that's progress. With haste.
That'll have to do.
Can't give up now. Might be useful.
Defender of the people.
On my mind, and well, in it. Wish I had a bag of holding. Mind my step.
Tin mask and torch stalks.
Hell of a combination. Get confused by one, or blown up by the other.
Mask and torch stalks. Hell of a combination. Get confused by one, or blown up by the other. Another day, another fight. These boots have seen everything.
Mask and torch stalks. Hell of a combination. Get confused by one, blown up by the other.
Lies before me. I'll fill my pack. good here, I hope. Corpses. These creatures did battle with Dwergar. Moving ahead.
Brought pain, and you will pay.
Going. Don't mind if I do.
Creature approaches. This ground is forbidden to your kind.
Have to keep going.
Slow down. Tormentor.
Battle favors the fearless.
Where do I go from here? With haste.
Intruder! Interloper! Invader!
Out with you, Eve Arisen.
Cut the blight away. Watch it wither.
What lies within?
On the victor's path. finding my way.
Ripple power could sustain an entire village if seeded.
Take that.
Don't.
Her condition is familiar. Poison, derived from a wild weed common to the Underdark. She'll need an antidote soon, most likely held by the poisoner.
Dwegor! Slashed me! Greys, don't share. Talking hurts. Leave me, please.
Like dwarves, Dwergar have innate resistance to poison, and thus no need for intricate brews. Though deadly, if left untreated, the poison can be cured by the antidote or natural remedies.
Not going anywhere. Ha!
Tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal.
Ha! Ha! So many minds connected. What could they accomplish? Ah, a visitor. You're a welcome sight. But let us observe the customs of the locals.
The scholar's brow tenses. His voice spills into your skull, the spores connecting mind to mind.
Blurg, proud member of the Society of Brilliance, at your service. Or perhaps not. Your mind is far more complex than that of the fungi. The feeling is mutual, friend. I have only passing familiarity with the surface races. But I found that there is as much to learn from an individual as there is from a community. So it is with the Myconids. They live in harmonious unity, but each has a unique personality. My colleagues and I are working to improve conditions in the Underdark. This need not be such a dire, hostile place. It's curious to find a surface dweller here. What has brought you down so deep? Truly remarkable. But why come to the Underdark, where they hold so much power? You were infected by an illithid tadpole? It's a miracle you're still intact. You must be worried sick, but have no fear. I have a friend who may be able to assist. Omelium!
I hope this is important, Blurg. My Zirkwood samples need constant attention.
It is. This adventurer has an illithid tadpole inside her head, but she hasn't turned.
No seromorphosis? That's impossible, but intriguing. Are you looking to have it extracted?
Geich, your head will make a fine trophy for my queen.
Please hold. I understand your rage against my kin. One of my brethren forced a tadpole into your eye. Or ear, perhaps? But I assure you, I stand with the Society of Brilliance, not the colonies of my people.
Fool! They infest your head and invade your dreams, and still you would parley.
I ask only that you refrain from violence. I respect that your opinion of my kind may be charged. If that settles matters for the time being, would you like a diagnosis? Open your mind to me. Let us see what lurks within.
As the Meloan's mind pierces yours, the tadpole pulses with power. It feels 10 times its size. Alive, awake, almost smug.
This is most unusual. The incubation period should be complete, as should your transformation. But the larva is infused with strange magic. It appears to be in some form of stasis. No, it appears to be shielded from physical and magical influence. And even without the shield, the extraction would involve severe cranial trauma.
Death. It means you would have to die first to extract the tadpole.
But not to worry. Should you transform, I will happily perform a new examination. The Nautiloi? Fascinating. I have never set foot on one myself. They were our warships during the greatest eras of the Illithid Empire. We ruled the entire astral plane from their decks. The design was lost when the Gith rebelled and ended our dominion. My apologies. I hope the experience was not too unpleasant. But I have an idea.
Oh, perhaps I should start taking notes.
There may be a way to bypass that stasis. There are many alchemical substances that can influence the mind. I do not intend to shatter its protection. I need only bypass the interference that prevents me from communicating with the lava. A tincture distilled from a collection of rare mushrooms. They have subtle psionic influence. I would require a fresh ton of madness and Timusk spores. But be warned, in their natural state, both of these mushrooms can be quite dangerous. Timusks cause confusion in those that approach them. The tongue is self-explanatory.
The Underdark, of course, although they are quite rare, and their discovery perilous. I imagine Lenore would have them in her possession. She served Mistra as a cleric. The southwest when I last saw her, although her tower does have a tendency to move. She is quite fond of her garden. Lenore has always been a lonely sort. Nature was her only companion. I offered her the chance to join the society, but she refused. Her experiments on Sousa bark took priority.
My formula will hamper the more harmful effects once the mushrooms are brewed into a potion. Your sanity, however much you possess, should remain intact. May your travels be safe and swift.